वेलकम एवरीवन, दिस इज एलएमएस कर्नाटक डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉलेजिएट एंड टेक्निकल एजुकेशन. एनीवे दिस इज महादेवय्या फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट एसके एसएटीआई बेंगलोर डीलिंग विद इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स. दिस इज मॉड्यूल 2 एंड सेशन 2 फॉर ऑल दी फर्स्ट ईयर इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू projection of straight lines after learning projection of points in the previous session. What is line? Line is very very important aspect of engineering drawing. Here we deal with only straight lines, we don't deal with any curved lines. What is the definition of the line? Point can be defined as an entity which has got its location but no dimension. But here, line can be defined as a point which moves along the straight path. Or in other words, it's the shortest distance between any two points, because we know that the line is always indicated by its end point. It does not mean that there are no other points in between. There are thousands of other points also, but we don't consider. So that means it's a series of points put together side by side, and only we consider the end to end points. Of primary importance. Of course, there is another important point somewhere in between the midpoint. So right now, it is the shortest distance between any two points. That the definition. Of course, there are different definitions for this straight line. We may consider as this the possible definition for the understanding of a straight line. So we always indicate a line by capital A letters, that is indicating the end points. So as AB, capital AB, RPQ or LM, something like that. So but normally the constitutive characters, okay? So we don't consider any two line as AZ or AX, something like that, no. So it is always AB or BC or CD, something like that. That's the idea. It has got its single dimension, that is the length. It has no width or breadth, whatever it is. So it's a single dimension entity indicated by a capital H letter, that is the actual line. So now, how to draw the projection, orthographic projection of a straight line? So the line can be any length. So normally we consider somewhere around 50 to 100 mm. Okay, it can be anything, but for the university point of view, examination point of view, we consider somewhere in between. So most likely somewhere around 80 mm, say. So this line, where to keep, because we have four different quadrants, the spaces. But from now onwards, you must understand that we consider only first quadrant. That is nothing but we do only first angle projection, nothing else. So it becomes easy for you to understand the entire projection principle with respect to first quadrant or first angle projection. So you know where to stand as an observer. You have to stand in front of the vertical plane to get the front view. Because the object lies between you and the projection, I mean vertical plane. So the object always lies between the observer and the plane of projection, which is nothing but the vertical plane. To get the top view, you have to imagine yourself that you are visualizing from the top as an observer. So there also the object lies between you and the plane of projection. We are going to project the front view as well as the top view onto vertical plane as well as the horizontal plane, and the convention remains same as because line is nothing but two end points, which is very very important. So they will be indicated. The same methodology is also adopted as we did it in projection of points. So then how many positions this line can exist within this first quadrant? So it is always n. Innumerable positions are possible. We can't deal with all those number of positions. So that is why it has been categorized into different cases. What are those? So here is the list. You can see line parallel to, that is case number one, line parallel to both the planes, that is HP and VP. So you imagine, you take a pencil or you take a scale, a assume that it has got only single dimension, no more, no other dimension. And then assuming itself as the condition parallel to keep that line as parallel to HP and parallel to VP, then draw the front view and draw the top view. So I will tell you, I will just read out all these things, what are the different cases. Line parallel to one plane and perpendicular to the other. So it is lying parallel to one plane, either VP or HP. Then it is obviously it's perpendicular to the other plane. So there are two cases, 2A, 2B. We will deal with that when we come to that. Line parallel to one plane, instead of being perpendicular, it is making some inclination. When it is 0 degree, it will be parallel. When it is a 90 degree to any plane of projection, it is perpendicular to that. So what you get is a point. Actually, you can't see anything on that. So if it is somewhere in between 0 and 90 degree, that is parallelism and perpendicularism. So then it is definitely, it is at some angle. And if this angle is considered with respect to HP, it is considered as theta, that is case 3A. And it's this angle is considered to be 5 degrees if it is with respect to VP. So that means the case number 3 is divided into 3A and 3B. So and what is case 4? So inclined to both HP and VP, this is the final condition. Basically, it's the combination of 3A and 3B. So if you understand up to case 3A and 3B, almost you are done with the projection of straight lines. Because case 4 is anyway a combination of 3A and 3B. But case 1 is the requirement for case 2, and case 2 is the requirement for case 3. That means you have to go from here, from case 1 to case 4. All these four cases, if you are done with that, then you will be ready to solve any kind of problem that may appear in the examination. But I would like to give you a hint that most likely, the problems always will be on case number 4. So that means case number 4 is very, very vital. Lot of concepts I will bring into that. You must understand before you start solving any problem related to case 4. So how to start? So the best way is to understand one by one. So we move on to case 1. So you know that line is considered to be parallel to both HP and VP. So in this figure, you see that EF is the line considered and it's parallel to both HP and VP. Whenever a line is parallel to any plane, you must always carefully listen to my words. Whenever a line is parallel to any plane, then the view on that plane will be in true length. That means when you project the endpoints, so and join them on the plane of projection, you get the front view or you get the top view, depending upon which plane you project. And when you measure that length, it will be exactly equal to the line itself, the actual line itself, that the idea. So I repeat, whenever a line is parallel to any plane of projection, then the view on that plane will be in true length. That means it is equal to the line itself. So if a line is parallel to VP, then the front view will be in true length. If a line is parallel to HP, then the top view will be in true length. That's the case 1. So how to draw that anyway? So we will solve, we'll take up a session where we will be dealing with solving the projection of line problems. Of course, the most important case is case 4. Case 2, you know that it is subdivided into 2A and 2B. This sketch shows, or this picture shows both the cases. If I consider a line AB parallel to vertical plane but perpendicular to horizontal plane, you can see that already we know that if a line is parallel to VP, then its view is front view. So that means, I mean, the front view will be in true length. That is A dash B dash will be equal to capital AB. And if a line is perpendicular to any plane, what you can see is only the end point. Because we are visualizing from the top, A is nothing but simply A. But B should have been shown over here inside the bracket. Anyway, we will do it in the while solving the actual problem. So B cannot be seen, so it is not shown here. But actually, you can show it or put it inside the parenthesis. So the B. As
The
the convention
convention
is
is
very
very similar
similar
to
to
projection
projection
of
of
points
points
also,
also,
because
because
we
yeah,
are dealing
dealing
with
with
the
the
line
line
just
just
by
by
projecting
projecting
the
the
point,
point,
end
end
points,
points,
and
and
later
later
combining
combining
those
those
points
points
we get the projection of line. That's the idea.
Case
Case 2B
2B
is
parallel
parallel
to
to
HP
HP perpendicular to VP.
So
So obviously
obviously
we know
not
that
whenever
whenever
a
a
line
line is
is
parallel
parallel
to
to
any
any
plane,
plane,
that
that
means
means
horizontal
horizontal
plane
plane
it
it
is
is
parallel
parallel
to
to
horizontal
horizontal
plane,
plane,
so
so
the
the
top
top
view
view
will
will
be
be
in
in
true
true
length.
length.
And
And because
because
it's
it's
perpendicular
perpendicular to
to
VP,
VP,
you
you
get
get
the
the
single
single
point.
point.
So it is because it's perpendicular, that is
A
A double
double
dash.
dash.
It's
Not
not
actually.
actually should now be A double dash. It should be D
Double
double
dash.
dash. Yeah, sorry, B
Double
double
dash.
dash. Say
D
D
dash.
dash. Sorry.
So
So
it
it
is
is
D
D
dash
dash
only.
only. It is
Not
not
shown
shown
that
that C
dash.
dash. It should have been shown as within the parenthesis. So
What
what
the
the
idea?
idea? So I repeat once again. In
Case
case
two.
two, whenever a line is parallel to any plane, then the view on that plane will be in true length. Whenever a line is perpendicular to any plane, then the view on that plane will be a point. So I hope this concept is very clear. So we move on to case three, which is line parallel to one plane and in plane to the other. Okay. So if
it
is parallel to
VP,
then definitely it will be, it should be considered as inclined to HP. So
and
that is the left hand
side,
the sketch which is shown over
yeah.
here. So it is
parallel
parallel
to
VP,
VP
but making inclination to HP. You
see
what
happens.
Because
it is parallel,
you
get
the
true
length.
And
the line considered is PQ,
two,
the capital PQ,
and
its front view is P dash Q dash. You see that. So
it
is in
true
length. Okay.
But
it is
inclined
at some
angle.
Angle.
That
angle
is theta.
Okay, it is
making
always
theta
degrees with HP.
What
happens
is
this inclination.
Assume
that
that
it is
even
that
parallel
to HP
also.
That
becomes
case
one.
So
it
is
both
parallel
to
VP as well
as
HP. So that means
whenever
a line is
parallel
to
both
HP and
VP,
both the views will be in true length.
But
here
it
is inclined
to HP.
That means it is
more
true length.
That
view
on
HP, that the top view will not be in true length because it is inclined to HP. So what is the
idea?
If any line is inclined to any plane, I repeat, if any line is inclined to any plane, then the view on that
plane
will not be in true length. That means it is distorted. So if it is, if
the
true
length
is 80 mm, then the
view
on
that
plane,
depending
upon
the
angle, the
more
the
angle,
more
the
distortion.
Here,
say
at
30
degree,
so it will get
distorted.
So you can
see
the top
view
is shorter, and also it is parallel. So the idea is very very important. So if a line is parallel to any plane, then the view on that plane will be in true length. If a line is inclined to any plane, then the view on that plane will be shorter, as well as that view will be parallel to XY line. This is a very very important concept. So you must
always
remember
these
concepts while solving the problem. So you can see here it is projected over here. While solving the actual problem, I will deal with all those things.
Similarly
here in the next figure, so it is
considered
over
here.
That is case 3B. It's lying
parallel
to HP. That means it will be true
length
on that, and it is
making
5
degrees
with VP, as shown in the
sketch.
So where
it
becomes
shorter
and parallel to XY line. So you can see clearly in the second figure. So the case 3B. So the
idea
is
same.
So
I repeat
once again
because
so
many
times
I
repeat in the class because it has to get into your mind. So
because
without
getting
these concepts into your mind, you will
not
be able to. I
guarantee
you that you will not be able to solve. So that is why I repeat: if a line is lying parallel to any plane, then the view on that plane will be in true length. If a line is
inclined
to any plane, whether it is theta with respect to HP or 5 degrees with respect to VP, then the view on
those
planes, either front
view
or top view, whatever it is, will be shorter and parallel to XY line. So we move on to final case. Here it is inclined to theta degrees to HP and 5 degrees to VP. So
I don't think
this is really, I mean, necessary over here.
Idea
is it is made to lie at an angle
theta
degrees to HP and at the
same
time 5
degrees
to VP.
Then
by
the
understanding of the previous 3A 3B cases, we can easily conclude that
it is
neither
in I mean
neither
top
view
is
in true
length
nor
front
view
in true length,
because
it is inclined to
both
HP
and
VP.
I don't think
you will
get
anywhere
in
true length.
That's
a
very,
very
tricky
problem.
Tricky
situation that exists. So
how
to solve
this situation?
How to come out of this situation?
Because
you cannot
take
anywhere in the true length. So it's all distorted. We do not know what is the distortion
value.
So
how much
has been distorted? It depends on
the
angle. So
very,
very,
because
always
true
length and true inclination goes together. That's another idea. Which can only be taken up with the actual problem. So we move on to the next slide. So this is the actual problem. So I will explain the entire
concept
what we learned from case 1
to
case 4. So we will be dealing, of course, this is the case 4 problem. Up to case 3A, 3B. So from the case 1. Of course,
all
those concepts
can
be incorporated as
relevant
to
this
problem.
So
I read out this
problem
for your understanding. So just look at this.
Line
AB, that means the actual line AB, and its length is 80 mm long,
as
it NA, 20 mm above HP,
HP
and 30 mm in front of VP. That means the line is actually lying in the first quadrant. One of its endpoint A is in first quadrant.
We don't
deal
with
any other quadrant, don't worry. So always we have to deal with first quadrant. It's inclined at
30
degrees to
HP,
that is theta value is 30 degree.
And
45 degrees to VP, that is phi value is 45 degree.
Draw
the projections of the line and find its
apparent
inclination.
Apparent
inclinations are its actually final
front
view and final top view will be at alpha and
beta
degrees. So anyway, that we will calculate from the sketch once it is completed. So how to go about it? I will explain. So
you know
that one of its endpoints is given. So that is A.
A
is 20 mm
above
HP and 30 mm in front of VP, which will be
drawn
as shown in this sketch with a thin line.
And
this is
A dash,
of course it's missing out. Anyway, you consider this as
A
dash
and
this is A.
Point,
the
projection
of line
always
starts with projection of end point A. Okay, so
that
we have
drawn
here.
Once
you
draw,
you clearly
draw
a
line
passing through A dash,
that
is called as the locus of A in front view.
And
draw
another
line which is shown
as
a chain line over here.
Thin
line, of course, 0.05 through
the top
view over here. And this is called the
locus
of A in the top view. Because
HP
is
below
XY-line, VP is above XY-line in first quadrant.
Now what
to
do with
that?
So
location
of
A
is
drawn.
What
are
we
rest
with?
I mean,
data.
So
its
true
length
is
now,
that is
80
mm. So how shall we start
with?
And its
true
inclination
is
given
30
degree.
That is
with respect
to
HP.
This
angle
with
HP
always
is seen in
front
view. So that means
30
degree
should always
be
taken
in
on
HP.
VP.
And
angle
with
VP
can
be
seen
only
in top
view.
That
means
it should be taken
on
HP.
So
you
must
assume
theta
degree
always
should be
taken
on
VP.
And
5
degrees
always
should
be
taken on
HP
because it is viewed in the
opposite
direction.
Opposite
direction in the
sense
inclination with
the ground
is always visualized in front view. So front
view
is
always
obtained
on
a VP. So that is why
angle
goes with that.
And
one
more
idea, the true
length
and true inclination always go together like
best
friends.
So
here you see that
30 degrees
is
taken
and a line
is drawn,
and
this
distance
is the
true
length,
that is 80
mm.
It is not marked over here anyway. So clearly understand that this is a line
at
80 mm and at 30 degree. And what
you
get is a
temporary
position
of
B, because it is not, what is the
idea?
It is assumed to be parallel to VP
at an angle
of 30 degrees to HP. So
that
is
case
3A, consider. Okay,
this
is 3A, what
we
are dealing with.
So
once
you
get this
front
view,
you
have to
draw
the top
view.
How shall we
draw?
So
draw
a vertical projector from
B1 dash.
Why is
B1
dash
not
B dash?
Because
it's a temporary situation. Because it is not lying
parallel to
VP.
because it is inclined at 5 degrees to VP.
Okay,
so that is why.
So this is a temporary condition.
Before we actually give the final inclination, we assume that it is 3A and 3B. We split this case 4 as case 3A and 3B.
So until it meets this horizontal line, which is called as the locus of A, you can see that if you refer 3A, you can see over here. So this is the shorter and parallel to XY line. That is what we are doing. Here also it is shorter and parallel when it is making inclination with VP. So A dash and B1 dash becomes A and B1 over here. So whenever a line is making 30 degree with HP, it will be shorter and parallel to XY line. So this is one part.
Now don't continue with it because we have nothing
over here. So anyway, while actual session, I'll actually show you how to drop step by step. Just I am explaining over here. Now you consider point A, that is the top view, and consider the true length at an angle of 45 degree, which is the true inclination. And you get A, B1, B2 over here. A, B2, because the top view, both are top view points. Now you project it until the point B2 is projected until it meets the locus of point A in the front view. That becomes B2 dash. So you can see here, A dash, B2 dash is the shorter and parallel to XY line. Now, we also know that what is shorter? Because it is considered to be making inclination with VP, and this is the front view, because it is at 45 degree. It cannot be in true length. But we know that its locus is over here. The point B locus is over here. It cannot lie over here. So you have to take it to this locus of B. So what we do is, with A dash as center, B2 dash as radius, we project it and it cuts over here. This is the final position of the point B. So this is called as the apparent length. And if you measure the inclination, this is apparent inclination. So which we can measure, and of course this always will be more than the true inclination. Similarly, this B1 has to be brought to its locus in the top view, with A as center and AB1 as radius. We rotate or we draw an arc until it cuts the locus of B in the top view, and we join these two points by a thick line called AB. Here also it is thick line, 0.4 mm normally. And if you measure this, the apparent length and the apparent inclination, you can show, you can see here it is 55 degree, but it is not shown over here. Anyway, we can measure, and probably somewhere around, because inclination is less, distortion will be less. So obviously you can see that, I think this is somewhere 45 degree, it is inclination is, I mean distortion is more. So the angle will be somewhere around 48 or 50 degree, somewhere like that. Okay, so this angle is can be measured, and it can be indicated. So this takes you to the end of the projection of line. Whether you understood the entire concept or not, you will definitely understand when I solve, actually doing it on a CAD system. I will show you using SolidWorks how to draw from the projection of point until the end of the projection of lines, until you get A dash, B dash, as well as AB. I think this is very clear. Thank you very much for your patient listening. So in the next session, we will be actually solving, in the lab session, we will be solving the problems, the actual problems which appear in a question bank. We will pick randomly some 10 problems and try to solve every one of them. Thank you for the time being. So until it is next session. Thank you.